Well, hi folks, this is Darren with My RV Works. A lot of folks that are watching our videos ask us questions, and this is an opportunity for us to jump in and maybe answer some of those questions. So if you like this, we're going to be doing a lot more of these things, and every one of them's got a little different feel to it. We'll jump into some different topics and things like that. If you like this kind of content, make sure you click that subscribe button, ring the bell, those types of things. That way, every week or so often when we come out with this kind of a content, you'll be notified right away. So without any further ado, let's go over to the shop and start answering some of these questions. Thanks for watching. Our next question is coming in from Darrel. Now, he didn't list where he's located, but that's okay. We'll still work with him. See if we can unravel the question. Now, he's got a Suburban water heater. His is 12 gallons. This one here is only 6, but the principles are going to be the same with what we're going to cover. Now, his problem is on the gas side when he flips his switch to LP for his water heater to work. He says that on the gas side, it's only running for 11 minutes. He's replaced the thermostat, which is in here, and he has voltage going to the board. Can you tell me what else I need to replace? Okay, so let's look at this. Now, the thing that's interesting that really caught my eye is the thing's only running for 11 minutes. Normally, these things will work or they won't work. They might fire off, but then within a few, not even 10 seconds, they extinguish themselves. So what I've got here is, here's your water heater, here's your thermostat. The first question I would ask you, Darrel, is, I have to ask it, don't hate me, is there water in the water heater? Okay, because if you're just heating air, it's going to get really fast. It's going to heat up really fast and your thermostat's going to trip off. So the way you verify if there's water in there, just kind of burp up this little lever here and see if water squirts out. Okay, so let's just make sure that we're good there. If we know that we have water in our water heater, then what I've done is I've got a gas valve. This one's actually from a 12-gallon water heater. So let's see here, it's going to go on, everything's upside down. Yeah, you're going to see that when you open up your water heater. You're going to see this right here, but the juicy side is on this side. So let's look at this gas valve real quick. We have two solenoids, which are redundant. They both need to engage. That's a safety feature. So they both need to engage in order for the gas solenoid to actually pull in. Okay. So we can assume that those are working okay. Okay, we can assume. What we also need to verify is that you have correct pressure, LP pressure, feeding this appliance. Okay, we've got other videos on pressure. You kind of need to be trained, licensed, insured, and everything to start working on LP on an RV. But just know that it very well could be that there's not enough LP pressure getting to the gas valve to create your flame. Okay, let's take a look at this electrode down here. Clean that up a little bit. This part right here, this little white ceramic part with the two little prongs, that is the electrode, and you'll notice that it should be right inside of the burner orifice. So here's the scenario. The LP gets introduced here. Let me back up so that everybody's focused. LP gets introduced into the input side of the gas valve. The dual solenoids engage. Gas is allowed to flow through this. It comes out a small orifice here, which we're going to be talking about because I think that might be where your problem is. It goes through the burner J tube here. It picks up some air along the way in this hole right here. So now I've got my Venturi effect. And now I have these electrodes will shoot a little lightning bolt between them. And once I have a flame, it rectifies a flame. The gap between these two probes should be about 1/8 of an inch. The gap is a function of the diameter of the probe, but in our industry, overwhelmingly, it's 3/16 or 1/8 of an inch. So right up in there is close enough. Larger diameter electrode, larger gap. Okay, but we're going to rectify that, and we're going to send a milliamp current through the flame. There's carbon in a flame. Okay, so we're going to use that carbon in that flame to be a current carrier between these two probes. One of the probes is bonded to ground. Okay, and the other probe is going to have this wire, like a lot of times there are these orange big, what would I call this, a spark plug wire. So the control board is basically seeing a milliamp current. I used to know what that rating was. The control board is going to see a milliamp current going through the flame to ground, therefore it knows that there's a flame and it keeps the gas valve open. Okay, so what could be a problem on yours? Well, you could have a cracked ceramic electrode. Okay, the way you would check that is you would wiggle these two probes. These are very stout. This is very good, but yours might be loose. Okay, therefore, the control board is getting an incorrect reading coming back from it. So your electrode could be bad. The gap between this, I mentioned it should be 1/8 of an inch. The gap could be incorrect on yours. Another thing, these can kind of be moved around a little bit. You want to make sure that your electrode is right in the flame, right where the flame's coming out. So it's right in the center meat part of the flame. So let's start with the electrode, because if the control board does not see the flame, it's going to shut down the gas valve. So let's make sure that the electrode is good. Let's make sure that we're right in our flame. First of all, let's make sure there's water in our water heater. Then we're going to make sure that the electrode's good. Your electrodes are nice and stout inside of the ceramic, that the electrodes are, the gap is correct, and we're right in the middle of our flame. Okay, make sure that our wire is good, that goes connected to this, it goes through the bulkhead of your water heater and then to that little, usually it's like a manila thing about the size of a deck of cards on the inside of your RV. So that's going to take care of all that, make sure that all that's good. Now on your Suburbans, you'll notice that there's this little pin. Let me see if I can get this here. This little pin right here that I'm going to pull out. Okay. It's kind of blurry, but let me just do it real quick. There we go. Okay. So let me, this little pin, this little clip. So that little clip right there, I just pulled, hold on. So this little clip I just pulled out of, that is what's holding those two pieces together. And it's going to go on that little profile right there. Okay. Once you've got your J tube out or your burner tube out, I like to take a can of office compressed air and blow through this, because you may have a spider web or a nest inside the J tube. So let's make sure that this is nice and clean. Okay. We've started with our electrode. Let's clean our J tube, burner tube. Make sure that this is clean. So now we know that we're good there. Now we're going to get into some fun parts. Now, every time you do these things, you could test it again. What I want to talk about now is the gas burner, the orifice. Let's see if we can get you focused. There we go. Okay, so this is where the burner tube was. And if you look very closely, let's see if I can get this rotated. There's a hole. So that's where the gas burner was attached. And there's that little bitty hole right there. Okay, now if you look, that can be taken off. There's your little flats. You can take that off and inspect this. A lot of times, little bitty insects, believe me, I've seen little teeny tiny insects will go inside that hole and make a nest in here, restricting the flow of gas inside of this. Now, if you need to replace this orifice, burner orifice, note that there is a one part number for a 6 gallon. There's another part number for a 10 gallon. So make sure you get the right part number. Where are you going to get that from? On your water heater, right inside on this side, it's going to have your serial number and model number. Model number, serial number, and from that you can get your part number for your orifice, okay? So your burner orifice. So, Darrel, I hope that helps. I mean, if you're getting good LP pressure here, coming on the input side, but I call it a refrigerator, what is this thing? A water heater. Golly, trust me, I'm a professional. Your water heater is not working correctly and it's extinguishing. It seems to me that the control board is not seeing the correct BTU at that location. So you've said you've replaced your thermostat. So it could have been your thermostat, okay? But it could also be that electrode. It could be the electrode wire. It could be the placement of the electrode. It could be that J tube because there's a nest or something inside of it. Or it could also be a nest or something inside of this, or this part here is just fouled. So I hope that helps, and let's jump into the next question. Well, folks, that's all the time I have today to answer some of your questions. If this added value to you, please like or subscribe to our channel. Share it with a friend that you feel it could add value to. If you want to support us, we have a Patreon. You can throw some love our way. It does take an effort to put these together, and it just helps offset some of that time that we put into it and some of the equipment that we buy to make it a better production. So thanks for watching. Happy campers say my RV works. We sure like saying that around here. And from the comments we're getting, we're helping you guys become happy campers too. So we'll be doing more of these Q&A videos, and make sure you add questions down below. And as a fun little side, let us know where you're calling in from or whatever, and we'll give a shout out to those. It's kind of fun to hear where everybody's at. All over the world, really. It's kind of exciting. So this is Darren on behalf of my RV works. We want to thank you for your time. It's a privilege.